excited that you all are here tonight. And I want you to just give your neighbor a high five. Like, whoever's close to you. Because, yes, I love it. So you all are here for a reason. You know, we're all wanting to grow in our own life, whether that is, you know, emotional, financial, business, or whatever it is that brought you here tonight. So you should be really proud of yourself just for showing up, because I know that there's always obstacles that happen. Whenever we are about to show up to receive something, that could possibly change our life. And I have a feeling, after hearing from all of these powerful women tonight, that your life is going to be changed for the better. And you are going to create new relationships, which will also change your life. So I'm excited. I have a couple of notes here, but I have a habit of not going by my notes. So that's why I have them here, to stay on track and to stay on time. And hopefully you all have your little notebook out to take some notes. I feel like writing something on paper is so powerful, and it really helps us to remember those things, because we're gonna hear a lot today. So take some notes, take pictures, whatever you wanna do. And you know, I'm so glad that there are some gentlemen in the room as well. Even though we're primarily women and we're gonna be talking about women things, I feel like having men in the room is great, just to give a different perspective. But and thank you, Bridget, for that amazing introduction. That was really cool. And you know, I feel like as women and as, you know, people in general, it is rare that we actually press the pause button in our life. You know, we have so much going on all the time that when do we press the pause button and actually take care of ourselves? So that's what I'm gonna be talking about tonight. And yes, you know, I am going to share a little bit about my journey, but I'm also gonna share a little bit about how I became unstuck. You know, the things that I had to overcome in my life to get to the point of where I'm at. Because there's a lot of that in between that I feel like people don't see and they don't know. You know, it's not just a boom, you're successful, like in one day, in a snap of the finger or whatever. And a lot of people, I think, sometimes think that. Or maybe they think, oh, you know, she was born into it, or she's just lucky, or whatever it is. Blessed, yes. Lucky, I don't know about that. So we're gonna talk about that. And I feel like also, you know, as women, we are so much alike. You know, we're more alike than we are not. And I used to think, not that way. I'll tell you all a secret, I'm being honest, I did not really like women that much. A long time ago. Yeah, I know. Can anyone relate to that? Oh, yeah. A couple people. So I didn't really like women. You know, I have been hurt a lot, like we all have from time to time. And because of that, you know, as we were talking about this back there too, but I had a big wall up. You know, I didn't want to let people in. I did not want to be vulnerable. I didn't want to be hurt again over and over. And I know that we've all had that in this room, even though we don't want to admit, because I was that person. No, I don't want to admit that I've had pain in my life or hurt in my life, but we've all had that. So anyway, so I'm gonna share a little bit of my background. You know, when I first started my Mary Kay business, and yes, you all probably saw that pretty pink Cadillac out there, but I was that person that said, I will never drive a pink Cadillac. I don't even like the color pink. I wore, you know, black and brown and gray, and there's nothing wrong with that, but I was an unhappy person on the inside. And I worked, yes, in a corporate environment, actually in healthcare. I was finishing a master's degree in public administration. You know, I was doing all the things that I thought I was supposed to be doing, you know, and I just felt like something was missing. I didn't know what that was, but I felt very unfulfilled. And I don't know if you all have ever experienced that feeling, or maybe you're feeling like that now, I don't know, but that was me. I felt like I was praying to God, like, God, what am I missing? What am I doing? What am I doing that is wrong? So anyway, I prayed about that for a long time, and kind of like, and of course we all work, whether we're a stay-at-home mom or we're working in corporate, we have our own business, it's all work. We are all working in some way. And yeah, I had a lot going on in my life at that time. I was probably the busiest person on the planet, Anybody else feel like that? Like, you're so busy, how could you possibly fit anything else in? So that was me. I did not think about having a business, a side hustle, anything like that. You know, I've never even heard of Mary Kay, actually. Anybody else like in that boat? Even though it's been around for a long time, I was like, yeah. And I was probably not your ideal candidate either, because I didn't know anything about makeup, and I probably washed my face with a bar of soap. So it's okay, you know, but God, you know, sometimes he has these plans for us where we're like, wow, really? I would have never imagined that for myself. So anyway, I'm definitely off of my notes here, but you know, another thing, yes, I was making a great income. However, I had made very poor financial decisions in the past. And because of that, I was still living paycheck to paycheck. And I felt like there was more month than money. Anybody else ever go through that? Okay, yeah. I know, sometimes we don't want to admit, but that was my life. And it was like all the time, working, exhausted, trying to get to that next level in my life, you know? And I guess one of the things I want you to think about, you know, is some of the things that are weighing on our hearts right now. What is weighing on your heart as a woman, you know, we all have those things, you know, that weigh on our heart, that keep us up at night, where we can't sleep, and it's this anxiety, and we're just thinking about it, you know, and maybe it's finances, or depression, or, you know, maybe we're praying for an opportunity. Like, that was me. I was praying, it's like, God, I don't know what I'm doing in my life, but I feel like I'm supposed to be somewhere else. Or maybe you have a job that you hate, I don't know. But anyway, I want you to imagine, just for a moment, you know, what would your life be like without that pain? You know, what if there was a solution to that, whatever it is that you are going through? And we all have something, even though we don't like to admit, every single one of us in this room, we have something like that, where, you know, it keeps us up at night, and we're like, praying about it, and getting all of this anxiety. It's a very familiar feeling to me. Anyway, so just a little backstory on me and why I am so passionate about helping women have breakthroughs, you know, emotional breakthroughs, confidence breakthroughs, financial, all of the things. So growing up for me, it was hard. It was chaotic. You know, there was a lot happening. We even lived in domestic violence shelters for a period of time. And when I was that age, I didn't quite understand all the things that were going on. But that can kind of give you an insight of what my life was like. I had a lot of people telling me that I would never amount to anything, that I was not good enough, and so many things. And because of that, I struggled a lot with low self-esteem and depression, anxiety, and I believed that. I stopped believing in myself. You know, I stopped believing in my dreams, because of all of those people that would say such negative things. And we are gonna be like the people that were around, right? So one of the things that we were talking about in the room, the VIP room, was you are gonna be like the top five people that you hang around. That includes finances. You know, if you're hanging around someone all the time, that they're like, you know, I'm broke, you know, this, I'm miserable, I'm so depressed. Like, yes, we want to help people, but also all of that, all of what we're taking in and hearing, our mind starts to fixate on that. And our life is going to be like that when we think about those things. And I'm sure you all have heard, what you think about, you bring about. So my life was full of that negativity. And I didn't know how to break out of it, honestly. I didn't even know that was an option. So, you know, growing up with that, and then I guess I felt like if I went to school, you know, got the master's degree and got the corporate job, that suddenly I was going to feel important, that I would feel validated, like I mattered. And the reality is, even after achieving that and getting the degree and having the great job and the paycheck, I did not feel any better. I did not feel important. I still struggled, but on the outside, no one would ever know. And maybe you all have something like that going on. And I share that just so you know, like, you're not alone in that. But anyway, so kind of where, when I started my business, yes, it's Mary Kay, and a lot of people think, makeup, skincare, and yes, we do some of that too, but there's a lot more to it. And anyway, I wanted to try the products, and I was that person where I was like, I don't really want to be here, I don't have time, I'm busy, I have things going on, but okay. And I met this woman, she was so inspiring. You know, she had one of those pink cars, and I was like, oh, I'll never drive that. And she was also making a six-figure income. Like, her highest paycheck was over $13,000 in a month. I was like, oh, okay. And she used to be a teacher. And I'm over here thinking, well, if she can figure it out, so can I. And I don't know what I'm doing, but I felt like, you know what? This woman inspires me, not because of the car and the money, but the joy that she brought into that room. And it was so long since I was around someone like that, with that energy and that joy and excitement. And I could just tell that she just loved what she was doing. Do you ever be around someone like that? And you're like, I want to be around them every time, every day. It's like addicting to be around someone so happy and positive. And my work environment was so negative. It was like, I know some of y'all can relate. Maybe that worked in healthcare, or maybe you work in like a very stressful environment where it's just negativity all day, every day. So I felt like, you know what? This could be my outlet to do something fun and of course make some money too. Anyway, so I signed up that night, and within 4 months, I actually earned my first free car with Mary Kay. And I had never had a brand new car. You know, I came from living the paycheck to paycheck mentality because that's what I knew, that's what I was taught. My parents, I love them, and I know they might see this, and that's okay because we've had the conversations, but you know, they did not teach me about finances. They made very poor decisions themselves, spent it on drugs, all types of different things. Even money that was for me, for my college, gone. And that was heartbreaking. However, that motivated me in a way to find my own way, to be successful and to make money. And I did, you know, go to college, I finished my degree. But anyway, so that free car to me was so cool because I never had a free car. You know that brand new car smell? I never experienced that until earning that. And I don't know, maybe some of you are in that place where you're like, you have this car, it's not super reliable, or maybe you're struggling with making that car payment. So I was there at all of those places, and it was super uncomfortable, but that's all that I knew. I didn't know that there were other opportunities, that there were women that could speak into my life and encourage me and empower me. I did not have that. So anyway, you know, fast forward to now, so much happened in between, and we're gonna talk about that a little bit. But I've been married now for almost 9 years, and I have two little girls. So I have a almost two-year-old, her name is Arabella, and I have a six-year-old named Aria, and then I have another little girl on the way, and we're still trying to think of names. And of course, you know, how many of you are moms in here? Like, okay, quite a few of us. But you know, of course, as a mom, we want to be there for our children. So I love that, you know, I get to do that and create my own life the way I want it. And along the way, yes, thank you for saying 7 free cars for Mary Kay, you know, hundreds and thousands of income and trips. We were able to buy our first house. And my highest paycheck so far has been over $15,000 in 1 month. And you know, I am not sharing that to brag. I'm sharing that because I came from a place where I did not believe in myself. I didn't think this was gonna work. I just said, you know what? I'm willing to try anything. It was either that or be a waitress part-time. And I have done that all through college, no offense, I didn't wanna go back to that. Those of you that have worked in restaurants, I don't know, can you relate to that? Because I was like, no, I'm not going back. But I want to say too that I'm not the exception. There are a lot of women doing what I do that make a six-figure income, over $100,000 a year. But what I want to kind of go into is I want to talk about what happened in that in-between spot, because that's the part that I feel like gets left out. You know, we see the success, we see the glitz and the glam and the trips and diamonds and money, but we don't see that growth that happens in between. So, and I did write some notes on this because it's not always easy to talk about the emotional shifts that need to happen for you to grow to that next level. So my number one thing that I went through a lot was, of course, you know, feeling worthy about myself, or feeling worthy just in general of anything. I did not feel like I deserved success. I felt like I deserved to live the paycheck to paycheck life, unfortunately, because that's what was engraved in my mind. And one of the things that I dealt with a lot was self-sabotage. And maybe some of you all have experienced that, where you get like this close to reaching the goal or the success, and then you pull back. Or something dramatic happens that somehow be caused. So that was me for many, many years. You know, I would sabotage my own success. And part of that also was because I had a legit fear of success. Even in my business, throughout the journey, yes, I became successful very quickly, but I wanted to move up to that next level, which was where I was stuck. And maybe you all are in that place now. But I felt like, you know, how can I be a good mom, a good wife, and be present and still be an entrepreneur and make a six-figure income and reach my goals? So I felt like I could not. I felt like it was one or the other, you know, doing the mom life, you know, being a wife, all the things, y'all know what I mean, or being a successful entrepreneur. And it took someone else speaking to me, telling me that I could do both. And for such a long time, I didn't believe I could. I thought it had to be one or the other, or once I get to that place, is my life gonna be crazy? Is it gonna be like I'm running around with like a chicken with my head cut off? Because the one thing that I do value is peace in my life. You know, I wanna have peace. I want to feel fulfilled, do what I love, spend time with family, but also have peace in my life. So that is one of my priorities. And I did not believe that was possible. You know, another thing was that I would not praise or celebrate myself for any reason. You know, I was so like, just caught up with the work and the accomplishing that any time that I had any accomplishment, I was like, yeah, okay, I guess that's a big deal, whatever. And I would keep working. So I wouldn't spend the time to actually praise myself, be like, wow, you know, Sarah, you did something great. And I want to ask you all, do you celebrate yourself? Do you celebrate your little wins that you have? Because we all have those little wins that we need to celebrate. So that was one of the things. And I felt like, you know, one thing that I learned was we need to value ourselves every day. Every day, value ourselves instead of feeling that we need to earn worthiness. And that was me. You know, there is this song today that I don't know if y'all have heard. It's like a praise song. It's called Gyra. Have you ever heard that?
Yes.
It is so good. And he talked about, you know, how we don't need to be earning trophies or any type of achievement to be worthy in God's eyes. And I never felt like that. I never understood that. So anyway, I just wanted to share that you are worthy. You are worthy of success. You are worthy of your dreams. You know, all the things that you have wanted since you were little. You know, someone said to me once, what are the things that you wanted when you were a little girl or, you know, a young man? You know, you had these dreams of things you wanted to do, right? Well, wow, she told me, like, I'm here to tell you that they can happen. And that's exactly what I'm sharing with y'all today, because maybe you have that dream in your heart and you just let people convince you that it's not going to happen for whatever reason. But this is me telling y'all, and I know that all of the other women would agree that it is possible for your life, no matter what age or what state that you're at. So the other thing that I wanted to share about is taking time to do things that you love and that you enjoy. Because that was another thing that I did not do. I felt like I wanted to just work all the time. And again, that goes back to the way I felt about myself, that I couldn't celebrate or praise for any type of win. And wow, I learned that self-care is so important. You know, and I'm sharing these things with y'all because they are so important to getting unstuck and moving yourself to the next level. You have to have that balance in a way of taking care of yourself and being a boss babe, right? So, you know, and I guess for me, every time I would try to take a day off, I felt shame. I felt like, Sarah, you do not deserve to be, you're not a millionaire yet. You don't deserve to be taking a day off. And I felt like that, and I would shame myself. And, you know, learning to break through that cycle of perfectionism and burnout, that was huge, you know? And so allow that for yourself. Even if you are working towards something really big and you feel like you need to work all the time, take a day off. And I want you to think about that now. What is something that you love to do for yourself? What is something that you could do to celebrate yourself and take care of you? Because for a long time, I didn't know what that was for me. I couldn't even tell you. I had to work on a lot during that process. Of starting my business, you know, to getting to the top 0.5% of the company. So anyway, I guess the other thing that I wanted to share, my other little topic here, was being vulnerable. So with what I do have a large team, and one of the privileges that I get is to speak into women's lives and encourage them and empower them. But like we were talking about earlier, I had this wall up. I didn't want to let anybody in because I've been hurt so much. And you know, talent can only take you so far. There comes to a point, especially as a leader, that we need to be vulnerable and share some of the things that we've been through. And of course, there's a time and a place for everything, right? But being vulnerable in a sense where I would have, you know, we can have conversations with each other about what is going on in our life and not feel like that person is gonna take advantage of us or go off and tell everyone our secrets. You know, like we were talking about that in there, just having that sense of vulnerability, that way you are able to grow in your heart. Because when you pour out to others, I 100% believe that that blessing is gonna come back to you in return. So, you know, that was something, that was probably the hardest thing for me, was becoming vulnerable and sharing some of my experiences, but also sharing in the pain that other people, specifically women, have gone through, because we all have that. You know, all of us have something. And I would also, like, whenever something bad happened or traumatic, be like, you know what, I'm just not dealing with it. I'm just gonna keep living my life and push that to the side. But it's so important that we deal with that pain. And sometimes I think that God allows us to go through these terrible things sometimes so that later on, that can be our testimony. You know, when we are sharing, when we've overcome, like, wow, how powerful is that? That you can share to someone else your story that can possibly change their whole entire life. So, you know, I believe in just sharing that, sharing your heart, sharing what you've been through, and of course, like, being mindful of your audience too. Anyway, so I guess the one thing that I wanted to ask y'all, if you are ready to make a change in your life, so you can raise your hand if you want, if you're ready to make a change in your life, you know, and, you know, I hear women say a lot of different things when I ask them that question, you know, and one of the things is, well, the timing isn't right. Like, the time is not right for me to make a change in my life. And I just want to say, the timing will never be right, because where are we right now? So we're in April. Okay, so next month there's going to be graduations. Then there's going to be summer, the 4th of July. Then what else is there going to be? Oh, Halloween. There's going to be, what's next? Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's. So there's all these big life things happening and a whole bunch of life in between. So there's always going to be things that hold us back from, you know, making a decision to move forward in our life. There's always gonna be something. There's never gonna be a right time. It's almost like you wanna drive home, but you're waiting until all the lights are green. That's never gonna happen, especially around here. But anyway, so, you know, I guess, you know, while in my closing, I want you again to think about, like, talked about earlier. You know, those things that are weighing on your heart. You know, and a lot of you came here today to break through of whatever that is. I don't know what it is, but you know, you're thinking of it, and it's different for every single person in here. And I want you to just imagine your life without that. And if there is a solution, because I'm pretty positive that one of these women that are speaking in this room could give you the resources to find a solution for that pain that you're experiencing. And I just want you to allow yourself to dream. You know, we just don't. Society does not encourage us to dream, and we settle. You know, we settle for less than what we could really have. You know, we were not made to just live paycheck to paycheck. I'm just gonna say, we are not made to just pay bills and then, you know, no, there's so much more to life. And I want you to think about, if you knew you couldn't fail, what would you do? If you knew you couldn't fail, maybe write that on your paper right now. If you knew you couldn't fail, you could do anything, what would you do, right? You know, and I think my favorite part of what I do, you know, I just love connecting with women and making a space where we can empower each other, you know? And I also love to help women dream again. Like, someone helped me to dream again, coming from a place where I didn't know how to dream. I forgot I even had dreams, you know, and really just help women to make that dream a reality. And again, I just want to ask you, if you're ready to have that breakthrough and live that life that you deserve. And the last thing I want to share, you know, every woman and man, just saying, we deserve to feel worthy. You know, we deserve to love our authentic self just the way we are, not trying to be like anybody else. Because that was another thing that I also struggled with, was trying to be like other people. So, you know, we deserve to feel that love for who we really are. And I encourage you all to just every morning ask yourself, you know, how can I show myself kindness today? And how can I show myself compassion? And the same that I would show someone else, like someone else that you love and respect, you give them that kindness and compassion. We need to be giving that to ourselves. And anyway, so why, whatever reason you all came here tonight, you know, whatever reason you are feeling stuck, you know, the key to stepping into that and out of it was really like, how do we prioritize that relationship with ourselves? And that's really the main thing that I wanted to share with y'all today, is how important you are. And I want you to take action, like, into stepping into your greatness and stepping into who God made you to be. So thank you all again for being here. And I'm excited to bring up the next speaker, even though I don't know who that is off the top of my head. So I believe that's why Ms. Bridget is here. But thank you all for being here, and I'm so excited to connect with you. I will be back there. And just thank you for being here and investing in yourself and your future. Yay! Did I tell y'all?